What's going on, guys? Welcome back. This video is on PD array and dealing range. In this video, I go over these concepts in detail. I'll explain what the array list is, and we'll go over the definition of each array and examples of them. All right, so let's get straight to it. These videos are meant for educational purposes only. Any trades taken in the financial markets are under your own discretion. The information taught should be demoed and only taken to live accounts under your own responsibility. ES Profitable will not be held liable for anything you do with the information presented. All right, guys, so the dealing range is the new trading range formed after buy side and sell side is taken. A PD array is the distinction between premium to discount inside that dealing range, including the array list inside the two ranges. So again, PD array is the distinction between premium to discount inside that dealing range, including the array list inside the two ranges. So we have an example here. This is a PD array. We have premium, P, premium, D, discount, and array is the array list. And this is your array list. We have old high or low, rejection block, a bearish or bullish order block, a fair value gap, a liquidity void, a breaker block, and a mitigation block. The same goes on the opposite side of the spectrum. So the goal is to find these arrays when price is coming back into either premium or discount. So for example, if you are a seller and you're looking to go short, what you would essentially do is you would wait for price to come back from a discount into a premium, and then you'll start looking for either a mitigation block to show up, a breaker block, a liquidity void, a fair value gap, a bearish or bullish order block, a rejection block, or an old high or low. All right, so this is the ranking of importance. However, as price is coming up into premium, you're actually looking at your entry in reverse. So you wouldn't essentially wait for price to come all the way up to old high, because that might not happen. So you're actually looking for price to touch a mitigation block. If that does not give you an entry, then you look for the next one, which would be a breaker block or a liquidity void or a fair value gap, etc. The same goes if you're looking for buys. If price is at a premium and you're waiting for price to come down into a discount for you to get into some buys, you would wait for price to touch a mitigation block, a breaker block, liquidity void, fair value gap, etc. And the old low would be the final destinations, if you will. All right, guys, so here we're looking at that PD array list. These are the elements of a PD array list. This is in order of importance. Again, old high or low, a rejection block, a bearish or bullish order block, a fair value gap, a liquidity void, a breaker block, or a mitigation block. All right, guys, so in this example, we're looking at price making its way above an old high. So again, this is number one on that list, old high or low. We're just looking at the high as an example. We see where price made an old high. It came back to take out that old high. All right, guys, so here we're looking at an example of a bullish or bearish order block. A bullish or bearish order block is the lowest or highest candle that has the most range between open to close and is near a key level. So if this was a key level, this would be considered a bearish order block. Price breaks down in market structure. Essentially, what you're waiting is for price to come back into the order block, and you would expect a reaction from the order block for you to get into some shorts. Here we're looking at the rejection block. All right, so what the rejection block is the area in between the wick and the high or low of the candle after a high or low is formed. We expect for price to reach that area and form a reaction from it. So again, the rejection block area would be, in this case, from the candle's high to the high of that wick. That area there is considered a rejection block. You would wait for price to break away, come back, touch that rejection block You would go short for continuation down. You could wait for price to react from that rejection block and then look for some shorts below the candle. So there are different ways to get in. Again, this is simply a basic explanation as to what is a rejection block. This is a chart example of a bearish rejection block. You can see where price made that high with the wick. Price broke down, came back, tapped right into that wick, into that rejection block, and continued down further. Here we can see a chart example of the bullish rejection block. We see where price created the rejection block. Price moved away from it, came back, tapped right into that rejection block, and then continued its bullish momentum. Now we're looking at the fair value gap. The fair value gap is a range in price delivery where one side of the market liquidity is offered and typically confirmed with a liquidity void on the lower time frame. So if this was price action and then you see that breakdown with displacement, you see the gap in between the bottom of this wick and the top of this wick, that range is your fair value gap. You would expect for price to come back into that fair value gap, give you a reaction for a continuation on shorts. If you're bullish, it would be the same thing, just in the opposite way. This is an example, a chart example of the fair value gap. You can see where price came back to fill in that fair value gap for a continuation. A liquidity void is a void left behind in price action due to a strong one-sided liquidity run. Price typically will want to revisit the void to rebalance the inefficiency. So we see price making a bearish displacement. Price is moving hard. There's one-sided orders. So price leaves this void. We're expecting price to later on to come back and to fill that void and to rebalance that inefficiency. It does not have to happen immediately. It can happen weeks from now, months from now, years from now. Eventually it does come back to it, but it is not obligated to come back to it immediately after it is formed. Now we're looking at a breaker block. A breaker block is the last down candle before the swing high. This is the breaker block. If this was a bearish candle, swing high was created, price breaks down. We're expecting price to come back into that breaker block for continuation bearish. Now this is a mitigation block. Mitigation block is a failed swing high that breaks down further and price, it traps buyers here. So price has a tendency to come back to mitigate that block and then continue bearish. Again, on these examples, you would be looking at the same thing in reverse if you were bullish on both the mitigation block and the breaker block. So going back and looking at this PD array, again, what you would be essentially doing is you're watching how price is moving from premium to discount, discount to premium. Let's say if you are bearish on a higher time frame, price is currently at a discount. You're waiting for price to come back into a premium. You would then be looking for a mitigation block, a breaker block, liquidity void, fair value gap, bullish or bearish block, rejection block, or old high or low. You can use multiple of these as a confluence when getting into a trade. Price can come back, take out an old high, break down, create a fair value gap, come back into it, and you can get in on some shorts. Price could also, for example, take out an old high, break short-term market structure, come back into the bearish order block, and then continue down further. Another example, price can come back, take out that old high, break down in market structure, come back, tap into that mitigation block or that breaker block, and then proceed to go down further. So as you can see, there's different variations of this, but the main concept here is to utilize the premium to discount array to determine whether you should be a buyer or a seller, and then utilize the array list to determine where your entry is going to be. All right, guys, so I hope this gave you a little more in-depth understanding as to what a PD array is, what the PD array theory is, coined by ICT. But again, just keep in mind that the PD array is happening in all different time frames, so you can be at a discounted area on a higher time frame, but in a lower time frame be in a premium. So depending on what time frame you're trading, and if you're scalping, if you're doing a day trade or swing trade, you know, you have to pay attention to all that, and then utilize the array list to determine your entries. All right, guys, so that's it for this video. Thank you for joining. I hope this video was insightful, and I'll talk to you guys next week.